thank you very much. It's a pleasure to contribute to this event from the HumMingBird project perspective, particularly on the challenge in international migration statistics and how we could work with it, especially with CESSDA, to improve the data accessibility of data and the facilitation of using data. Before I go to that, I just want to briefly introduce the HumMingBird project. It's a Horizon 2020 project which aims to understand and to see the needs for the changing nature of migration flows, drivers of migration, to analyze the patterns, motivation, and the new geographies that are emerging in migration, as well as to use the whole information and the data that exists in order to forecast and foresee the emerging future trends in migration. The project is encompasses a large number of partners. The consortium have people or partners from different 10 different countries with very diverse backgrounds: sociology, anthropology, computer science, political science, data scientists. We have working with us within the project, but we don't stop there. So we still have private companies, SMEs, NGOs. Those NGOs, especially working in the ground with the migrants and migrations in different regions. Also, we have a European Research Infrastructure Consortium with us. So basically, the idea is that how we could use mixed methods, how we could use different methods of qualitative and quantitative to basically provide a better understanding or provide how we could build better scenarios in order to understand migration better in the future. So within the HumMingBird, we are not only collecting and making data available, but we are also trying to analyze and put together those data. Yeah, the data includes like the statistical data or traditional data. Then we have big data analytics, and also the assessment of the alternative sources for the data that is not available or there is a problem with accessing those data. Yeah, then we are also collecting and gathering qualitative data through qualitative approaches, different methods that exist there. And then we combine those data. And also we also see the disconnect or the connect between the migration theories and migration data, to what extent the existing data corresponds to those. So this is a large project, and I'm not going to explain everything about the project. I'm going to just explain what I did within this project. So in order to understand the data or migration data, we needed to first conceptualize the gaps in migration data or the challenges in migration data, especially in the traditional data, so that we could move forward and how to find ways to improve them and to tackle those challenges. For that, for the last 2 years, I have been monitoring the existing data sources as well as the academic literature in order to see what the academia says and what's the data. We know that over 100 years, countries have been collecting data, that they are projecting data, but we know that the data could not fully correspond to our needs. And then this needs to be conceptualized, because we see that in almost every academic paper, they say that we have problems with the demographic characteristics, different other sources of problems. So overall, how we conceptualize these gaps, we categorize them in five different categories. We have a large HumMingBird report, which was published last year. You can see that on our website. We conceptualize the gaps based on definitions and measurements because countries and regions, they collect data under different definitions, and then they provide it for the platforms. And then they project it as one data, which creates a lot of problem for the accuracy of the data. Then there is the gap of demographics, like the demographic characteristics of people there are not really elaborated. And again, it creates problem. The drivers or reasons behind the data, the migrations are not always there in the data sources. The geographical coverage is another problem that some countries collect really good data, and then some countries they don't collect data, and then there are estimations for those countries, and then these data are combined together and projected as one data, which really brings down the quality of data, and then the timeliness of data. Some regions they have very good data and they update them, but then some data is not online, and even the UN data is in 5-year basis or 2-year basis data. Even the Eurostat, which is more developed one, it still takes 1 or 2 years until we have the data complete there in their system. So with the HumMingBird, we are now trying, I'm currently in contact with over 50 national statistical offices to find out how we could improve these. And because the project started just last year and we are in the second year of the project, so we will have more data and information on this on the website, but we already have the other data which we are using also in this project, including big data. For example, we, as part of the HumMingBird project, we see at the satellite data how this how this impacts migrations. For example, one of our outcomes are already on the website in the case of Somalia, how drought pushes people, or how this drought there creates migrations. Then we have other sort of data that we look into seasonal migration. We look into the refugees and all of those. But then still, there is always the question of how big data could complement, or how big data could be used to cover those gaps that exist in the statistical data. So what I talked with some of the statistical offices, they already use big data to cover some parts of their statistics. But then there is always the question of reliability and the question of how the data could correspond to the needs that we have, and how they could help us with completing our statistics. Then a migration policy indicators is also one of the objectives of the HumMingBird project, to have like a comparative assessment of the migration policies through the use of different indicators. And for the moment, the focus is mainly on migration, admission, residence permit, and nationality acquisition. But we have a report on this on our website, so that you can read, and you can see how those are tackled. So in the future, with the HumMingBird, we will also we are also collecting very large amount of or a considerable amount of qualitative data to have a hearing of immigrants, to see what they are saying. But unfortunately, we cannot make that data available for the public because of the sensitivity and the privacy, but we will still have to some extent the metadata and information about those data available. So this is basically it from my side, from the HumMingBird project. I will be happy to respond to your questions regarding the HumMingBird or the work that we did. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Ahmad. That was very interesting also to see how the time sensitive also affects you. Maybe with the new with the new developments around COVID-19 data and the fast track publications, this may fly over.